there's not enough energy for the people that are already on the planet. And as the population gets larger, the amount of energy that we need to produce as a world is obviously going to get higher. Between 2008 and 2035, the world energy demand is expected to increase by 36%. So at the present time, there's approximately 1.3 billion people who are currently without access to electricity. What we're interested in doing in the Nanoscience Lab is finding ways to make energy production cheaper or more efficient.
So the real challenge is finding a way to bring down the cost of solar energy so that it's really competitive with other sorts of energy technology. Eventually, when we do run out of fossil fuels, we need to be prepared to make the switch as seamlessly as possible.
Brandon Macdonald's a Canadian who's come to Australia to do research in nanotechnology. According to The Age, he's been listed as one of the top 100 most influential people in the city of Melbourne. He's also won recently the DuPont Award, which is quite prestigious and brings with it a lot of prestige for both Brandon, but also the group and the work that we're doing here in Melbourne.
You're trying to do things that nobody's done before. And so you spend a lot of your time learning how to deal with failure, really. After so many days of failure in a row, it can get quite discouraging, and it takes a while to sort of pick yourself up and get back in there and try something else. It really taught me the value of just hard work and having to put in the effort if you want to succeed. Having success definitely makes it easier to get out of bed in the morning and come into work. And I've also been very fortunate to have a great team of people who work with me and around me every day.
The research that we do in our lab, it's critical that we do it in a multidisciplinary environment like Bio21.
One of the high points of doing my PhD would be sort of the first time we realized that this method we developed for making solar cells worked. That was really the eureka moment, and everything I've done since has followed on from that event.
Once we make the nanocrystals in solution, we then process them into an ink, which we can deposit onto surfaces such as glass. These absorb the light that enters the cell and help create the current that we're able to generate.
We use nanoparticles in solar research as foundation for the light absorbing material and the charge conducting material in the solar cell. And basically we take nanoparticles in solution, and using them as an ink, we can produce many of the layers that you would have in a typical solar cell. Brandon Macdonald has focused his efforts recently on cadmium telluride based solar cell devices, and essentially doubling the previous record efficiency for these types of materials.
One of the goals of this work is to simplify the entire process, and that should bring down the costs. It's likely that we'll be able to make cells which are cheap, lightweight, and flexible in the future. And that should extend their application so they're not just on rooftops or large-scale arrays, but you may now be able to incorporate them into other things such as solar windows or backpacks.
The other benefit to using nanoparticle-based electronics is that they can be printed from sort of typical printing technologies, and in doing this we can actually take the technology out of large-scale production facilities and actually produce these types of materials anywhere on the planet.
It's never been my goal to be a great scientist. It's actually my aspiration to just use my knowledge and my skills to try and address some of the big global challenges. And I think of science as a tool to try and work towards this.